Hey, welcome to this Windows channel, and this is the Tech News Update. We are Wednesday, January the 25th, 2017, and today in our Tech News Update, we have Satya Nadella, the CEO at Microsoft, that is joining the board of directors of Starbucks. And the reason behind this, because at first I thought Starbucks, coffee, and Microsoft Tech, what's, you know, the link? But it seems that Starbucks wants to understand how tech is used around the world and actually find out what would be cool things to do with tech and their own clients. So that's kind of interesting. I wonder if it's going to bring, you know, a host of maybe new services that Starbucks will introduce into its stores. But that's going to be kind of cool to see that. And interesting to see that, you know, Satya is actually going to talk about tech at other companies. Well, there's an insider release preview that was released, so don't look for updates right now if you're just a regular Windows 10 users. But the release preview ring has an update that's 14.393.726, which makes us think that a bug fix and all sorts of little updates are coming to Windows 10 in the next few days. So, of course, we'll be checking that out. And as soon as it is released for everyone, we will talk about it and see what are the updates in this release preview. Of course, the release preview ring is that ring where they test updates before they are sent out to everybody. So it's going to be interesting to see what this brings to our Windows 10 operating system. Netflix Everywhere. Well, you can now download shows and movies on SD cards if you have an Android device. And you know what? I actually went to my Netflix app on my Android phone to find that, yeah, it actually works. I can download to the SD card TV shows that I want to watch later. So this is cool because if you have very limited data caps on your smartphone, for example, well, that's pretty cool, or even an Android tablet. You can download TV shows and movies and on your Wi-Fi and then watch them later. So that's an excellent idea. And of course, that is something that a lot of streaming providers are kind of a little scared because they're afraid that somebody somewhere could actually steal TV shows and movies through this. Samsung, despite the recall of the Note 7, that cost them anywhere, you know, some numbers are at $2 or $3 billion, but there are some reports that it could have cost and will cost Samsung up to $5 billion for this Note 7 fiasco. But still, some strong four quarter profits. So in the last quarter of 2016, they are actually showing a few $1 billion profits. So that means they really are making a lot of profits if they can actually go through the Note 7 fiasco and still make money. So, of course, with the new plan of, you know, how to test the batteries and everything, I think the future of Samsung might be okay if they are more careful about what they're doing. Vivaldi is a browser for Windows and not used by a lot of people, actually, and a lot of people probably don't know what this is. But the CEO of Vivaldi is actually asking Microsoft to change its ways. Vivaldi's CEO says that Microsoft Edge in Windows 10 is too difficult to remove as the default browser, and that is a big problem for competition. And he says that Microsoft needs to do something about this so that it's easier for any other browsers to get into Windows 10. You know, I give credit to that because, yes, it is more difficult to try to remove Edge than previous versions of browsers like Internet Explorer. Yet, you know, Google is at 50% of the browser market right now, and they are going well. So it shows that, you know, somebody somewhere can do something about it. But, of course, Vivaldi doesn't have the enormous potential that Google has. Well, if you are a Windows Insider and you've been on the program for a while, you will receive an email survey. I did receive it personally yesterday. So pretty much every insider will receive this email survey, and this will help the program redirect itself in 2017. There's a lot of interesting questions in there, and I think they want to change the insider program to have a more, more cooperation between people and have people in different cities. Like for example, one of the questions that was interesting is, would you like to have groups of insiders in your own city and meet with them and things like that, which is kind of interesting actually. So this is of course pushing out to all the insiders. Take the time to answer the survey. I think it's very interesting, and be constructive. And of course at the end, well, you get a chance to win a Windows Store certificate for worth for like $1,500. HP issues a laptop recall of more than 100,000 batteries over complaint of overheating, but also HP is kind of scared that, you know, laptops might catch fire. So I will issue a separate video where I will actually give you all the details of where to look and what are the affected batteries. So stay tuned. I will post a video in the coming hour after this news bulletin giving you all the details. So it seems that some HP batteries anywhere from 2013 to 2016 on some models are actually really overheating too much. So check out my video. I will actually give you links and details of this recall. In other news, Google I/O, the developer conference, has been announced, and it will be May 17th to 19th, 2017. Google I/O, you know, in the past years was for a long time something that wasn't that interesting, but as Google is getting more and more into the hardware business and into all sorts of services, it's getting more and more interesting to actually watch the keynotes and have more of the information of what's happening in Google I/O. So of course I will be covering this in the month of May. So May 17th to 19th is when it's all happening. Well, 3 months after really working hard to remove fake news, Google says that it's banned 200 publishers from its services and AdWords, and they cannot monetize fake news anymore. Google really taking very seriously the fake news that's going on through its networks. And of course, 3 months after, 200 publishers are banned, and more to come apparently. So, you know, if you're publishing fake news like the ones you see here on the news bulletin, I can just tell you one thing. This is not gonna really work for you in the future, I think. DuckDuckGo, this is a search engine that actually is basically anonymous in your search. Basically, when you go and use DuckDuckGo, nothing is saved anywhere. And your the reason behind DuckDuckGo is to really make you anonymous while you're searching on the internet. Well, DuckDuckGo is celebrating 10 billion anonymous searches this week. So it seems that a lot of people are using DuckDuckGo, and it's a you know, interesting project. I think it's useful to have something like this working, and let's hope that it continues on for a long time. And finally, in our last bits of news, Ruslan Stoyanov is a head of cybercrime investigations at Kaspersky. Well, he's got arrested. And that's an interesting story because I will be reading a little more on this. We have all sorts of reports. We know that Kaspersky is close to some Russian spies. We know that there's a lot of things happening with Kaspersky. And, you know, it's not totally clear exactly what is happening, but we know that he's been arrested and could be accused of high treason in Russia. So what exactly happened and what's the behind-the-scenes story? I'm actually looking at more and more details to kind of maybe have a little kind of a scoop or more information on what's happening. Hopefully maybe for tomorrow's From the Couch show. I think it's going to be an interesting topic to talk about with what's happening at the Kaspersky Labs company and this head of cybercrime investigations that's been arrested. And so this was the Tech News Update for Wednesday, January the 25th, 2017. You enjoy our videos? Why not subscribe? You'll know when new videos are online. Give us a thumbs up. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions, let us know. Thank you so much for following us on this channel.